tonight on Access TV. Live live with Gotham Comedy live. Get ready to laugh.
Uncensored, unscripted, and most importantly, it's live.
With Louis Katz, Marina Franklin, Colin Jost, Lynne Koplitz, and your host, Jim Norton.
Hi, I'm Jim Norton. And if there's any women out there with large clitorises, please email me at therealjimnorton@gmail.com.
From the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City, live, all happening right now. Ladies and gentlemen, your host, Jim Norton.
Welcome to Gotham Comedy Live. Thank you very much. And let's all pretend that we're not humiliated that I'm wearing the same shirt in a different color that you just saw in that stupid promo. Could I have worn a fucking gayer shirt? That was the shirt Robert Reed died in, and I wore it for a promo. Well, I appreciate you guys coming. I feel good. I've lost weight, and like I don't know how to take a compliment. Like, because people tell me, like, hey, you look like you lost a little weight. And instead of just going, like, thanks, I, like, downplay it. I'm like, oh, well, yeah, there's more work to be done. And then they're like, yeah, where do you want me to go with that? Obviously, shithead. Because then I act like they were saying, like, Jim, you're fucking perfect. It's finished. I need to get laid badly. I really do. And I'm not above spending. If there's anybody here that's, like, behind on your rent, I'll fucking hand you cash. Because I'm creepy. Like, I don't mean to be creepy, but, like, I lick my lips a lot, and that's a turnoff. Because you don't realize you're doing it, but it really does give a real rapey vibe when you don't mean to. It's like, I do good until I lick the lips. Like, so where are you from? And clearing your throat. Like, I never realized how, because I, you know, I'm kind of lactose intolerant, so if I... I'm not just saying that to really turn you four on, either. That's a very sexy thing to tell a girl right out of the gate. You know, I can't drink milk. It's awful if you're going down on her. Like, no, it's not you, it's me. I had a block of cheese earlier. But the problem when you clear your throat is you always sound like you're lying. Even if you're telling the truth, you sound like a liar. Did you touch that child? No. So, I want to get a hooker because I want to treat myself. And I guess I've been out of the hooker loop for a long time. I called an escort agency and I'm like, well, I want to see a girl. How much? And she goes, $3,000. I'm like, did she stay forever? Like, does she bring all of her shit and I can just fuck her until I'm 80? She goes, no, that's for like an hour or 90 minutes. I'm like, wow, $3,000, do I get to cut her head off and keep it when I'm finished? Not that I want to be violent, but just so I could talk to her, like, you know, hey, was that a good fuck? And then I could hook up a little string and like, and her head would go like. You're a really good crowd. And there are a lot of women here. And I really am fucking, I'm horny. I'm not just saying that, like. You know, it's like, I watch a lot of pornography and I'm not saying that that's, I'm, you know, maybe that's bad for an introduction, but there's four very nice girls. I'm a good dirty talker. I hate when you talk dirty to somebody and they give you nothing back. You're like, yeah, you like that shit? And they're like, uh-huh. It's like, do you want to fucking expound on that? I feel like I'm committing a felony right now. But I don't relate to the sex. People talk about pornography being dangerous. I don't relate to the sex in rated R films. I think that's worse. Like, you ever watch a Michael Douglas movie? Like, the sex they have in those movies is so disconnected from the way I actually make love. Like, watch any Michael Douglas movie. He walks in the door with a woman 30 years younger than him. And instead of walking down the hall into the bedroom, there's always a little end table right by the door that he just can't wait to stick it in. So he has to knock all this shit off the end table and put her up on the table and maybe I'm just too OCD, but was it a turn off? I'd be like, ah, don't knock that off. Be careful. I spent a lot of money on that. Careful. And the funny thing to watch in these movies is that they can't show anything below the waist, so they have to indicate everything through upper body movements. And they always have a lot of passionate kissing, and you always know that she's pulling her panties off just by the little lift. Like, she'll do that little shoulder lift and hip, and they kiss and they maintain eye contact, and you know he's pulling out his, of course, erect penis. Because the hip goes back a little bit and he fumbles, and he's not gonna drop his pants, because why would you do that when you could just pull it out through two jagged strips of metal? That's always the best way to do it, is to get a mini bear trap and just yank your dick out through that, because, you know, sex is nothing if there's not a threat of a beheading. And you know that they begin sex because during the kiss, there'll just be that little knowing grunt. And then they make love. They do all of this, by the way, without looking down once. If I try that without looking down, 10 times out of 10, I wind up in the emergency room. I either bend it backwards on her thigh or I break it on the desk. It's so unsexy the way I do it. Like, how do you not look? If I want to stick it in, I have to take out my iPhone and turn on the flashlight app. You know, and of course, I have to use my fingers and manually get her ready. Look, I'm sorry, but it's just not a turn on for her. When I'm like, you know, careful, Ozzy signed that. Don't let... And I'm trying to put it in, but I'm losing my erection. And I'm like, could you just tweedle my nipples? You ever ask a girl to tweedle your nipples while you're holding an iPhone? By the way, have you ever just tried to force it in before you go totally soft? You're hoping that you can just kind of jam it in quickly before all the blood drains out of it and goes down to your cankles. It's like you're trying to slide under the metal door in War Games. Just hoping that if you just get the head in, like the suction of her lips will puff it up. Like you ever try to get a cigar started? They don't show you that in rated R movies. How come Michael Douglas never needs a blowjob to get ready? Why do you never see Michael Douglas on a sofa with his legs open and shaking, just tweedling his nipples with his shirt undone and sweating on his forehead and the girl looking up like, are you okay? And he's like, yeah, I'm enjoying it, I'm enjoying it. And she's like, well, I'm not. I feel like I'm molesting you. Can I go home now? This is creepy. You guys are a fucking good crowd. You know, it's funny, the most common question, people always say, like, what do you do if you tell a joke and it bombs? That's what people are afraid of. And that's not scary for a comic. It happens to us every night. For joke bombs, just go on to the next joke. The reason it's scary for you is because in your own real lives, you don't have the next joke option. You understand? Like, for me, if I bomb, fuck you, you paid, I didn't, and I just keep going. I mean, that really is the only choice. I mean, what am I gonna do? You know, feed you all mescaline and then run around the room tickling you as I retell it? But you've all bombed in your real life and you just have to sit in it. I feel worse for you. Like, you ever try to be funny and the joke bombs so badly, you actually have to play it off like you didn't mean it to be funny? You ever try to act like it was a real serious statement? Like, it bombs so fucking badly, it might have been serious. Like, and you try to play it off by going, oh, I'm just saying. Like, you're at work, your boss comes in, there's no I in team. You're like, well, there's two in syphilis. I'm just saying, you know, yeah. Be careful, wear condoms. God bless. By the way, I give really good oral sex to any women that might. No, and I know I'm good because I stop every 30 or 40 seconds and go, huh? Is this a turn off if I'm going down on you and you go, I'm gonna come, if I stop immediately and go, what'd I tell you? Are you all single? You got little tattoos, it's really sexy. You're welcome. You have none, and I think that's sexy too. Oh, vaginas. Well, you guys are a fucking good crowd. 8 hot women up front, and my goal is I will fuck one of you tonight. Woman, tranny, or man, one of you is going down. We have a great show tonight. I know all the comedians on the show. Are you guys ready? Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Minute and a half. Stay there.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV. Live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Louis Katz is taking the stage when we return. Welcome back to the Access TV presentation of Gotham Comedy Live. More laughs happening right now.
We're back. Thank you. Your first comic is a good friend of mine. You might have seen him. He's had his own special on Comedy Central. His new CD is called If These Balls Could Talk, and he's really funny, so make him feel good. Louis Katz.
Thank you. Thank you very much. How's it going? Thank you. Only got 9 minutes. Stop. All right. Thanks. You guys good? Doing pretty good myself. I had a great day today. I spent most of today balding. I really got a lot done. I feel good about what I got done. Sucks going bald. I'm not sure what to do about it. I can't cover it up with a hat because I wear glasses. Can't wear a hat and glasses. That's like a fake mustache away from being in disguise. I actually grew a mustache earlier this year because I thought that would help distract from the balding. Yeah, that's a good idea, right? Yeah, no one will notice I'm losing my hair if I just make myself look gayer and creepier. Why bother with the mustache? I could just get some cut-off shorts, pet lizards, start rollerblading around the neighborhood, just... into weird stuff though, guys. I like to smell things that shouldn't be smelt. You know what I'm talking about? Right? Clean your ear with a Q-tip, then you check it out a little bit, like, ugh. What's that all about? Clip your toenails. Ugh, why is it so cheesy? Weird. Like, you know, sometimes someone's got really bad breath, and you like lean back a little bit. Just to get out of range, you lean back. I lean back, then I lean in. Right? Some people's breath is so bad, it's mysterious. You just want to figure it out. Like, how did it ever get to be that bad? No one ever bothered to pull you aside like, hey, man, come here. You know, there's no such thing as street chocolate. You've been eating dog shit. That's dog shit on your breath. The other day, I was walking around here in New York, and I saw a homeless guy coming my way, and he just looked really smelly. You know what I mean? Like, one of these guys, like, I know why you're homeless, because it's a full-time job just being this dirty. Like, how did you even get that filthy? Is there a coal mine somewhere in the Lower East Side that I don't know about? Did a wascally wabbit put a carrot in your shotgun? What the fuck happened to you? So I start getting ready, right, avoiding eye contact, breathing through my mouth. But I see him pass by out of the corner of my eyes, I decide, you know, I still want a sample. So I take just a little, like, just to see how bad he smelled. And turns out, he didn't smell bad at all. I felt like a total jerk. Then he got 10 feet past me and bam, it just hit me. Like, this guy was so nasty, his own stink didn't want to kick it with him, okay? That's how bad it was. But it wasn't that typical homeless guy smell, you know, urine mixed with BO on. That's hack. This guy's smell had depth, it had originality, it had like the sharpness of a foot funk, yet with the earthy undertones of like a high-grade street chocolate, you know? I'm talking like 70, 80% caca content, you know what I mean? Really classy stuff. There's a real complexity to a smell, as if someone taking a diaper full of blue cheese and beating a wet dog with a burnt butthole, you know? What did I tell you about sitting on volcanoes? No. That's how he burned his butthole. Sitting on volcanoes. I'm trying to be healthier these days. I don't like being healthy. I don't like the ways they try and get you to be healthy. Like all the ads trying to get you to quit smoking on TV. I don't smoke, but still it bothers me. They always tell you, don't smoke, because smoking kills. And that's not cool. Yeah, well, all the smokers know that smoking kills. They're still smoking. That's what's so cool about them. Right? Yeah, these smokers don't give a fuck. Now, healthy people aren't cool at all. Healthy people are pathetic. Healthy people are like death's bitch, just all the time. Like, oh, please don't kill me, death. Oh, I promise I'll eat all this bland health food. Oh, I'll run every day on a treadmill. Oh, I'll fuck with a condom on every time. I'll fuck with a condom on. Please don't kill me. Nah. Dead. Smokers are just like, fuck you, death. I'm gonna do this myself. Thank you. All the healthy food sucks, man. Like salads, people tell you, anyone tells you they actually enjoy eating salad, that person's a fucking liar, right? No one likes eating salad. It tastes like crunchy air. It's no good. Never satisfied after eating one. It's like the dry humping of eating, you know? I mean, seriously, I'd rather toss a salad than eat a salad, okay? Try to get you to eat tofu, that's another thing. Oh, have some tofu, yeah, no thanks. That's like Jell-O with tuberculosis. Or if you want to, at a deli, you want to have a healthy sandwich, what do they say? Oh, have the tuna fish. Enjoy the tuna fish. No, have you tasted this shit? It's fucking disgusting. I'm not having the tuna fish. It's horrible. You know, they say that tuna fish smells like stinky pussy. Okay, first of all, immature. Second of all, that's an insult to stinky pussy, okay? Stinky pussy has never stunk that bad, and it's got stinky in the name, for real, okay? Tuna fish on wheat, no thanks. I'll take rotten snatch on rye any day. And maybe I'm a bit biased. I happen to like a little stank on my puss. Not like a nasty, garbagey smell, but the kind of smell like, well, I should really wash my hands, and you go to wash your hands. Well, goddamn, it's still there. Still there. And now I got memories of the good times that I had. And that's better than a postcard. Lately, what I'm doing with women, when I hook up, I put my whole face in it. Like when I go down them, I just put my whole face, just like, it's not even for them, it's just for me. Just, I love that, you know? The only problem is, like, a little while later, I got, like my face is kind of, like, all, like, I mean, I got, like, kind of crunchy, you know? I got residue, pussy crystals all up in my eyebrows and shit. Oh. Pussy crystals. I'm just glad to be having any sex at all, really. When I was in high school, I never got to have sex. I had a girlfriend, but there was no sex from her. She was very religious, saving herself for marriage. So we could only make out. I couldn't even, wouldn't even let me feel her up. That's not in the Bible, thou shalt not feel on a titty. That's not in there. All we do is make out for hours and hours and hours. And that's, you can only make out for so long. It's like, what the fuck are we doing here, you know? Because making out, it's like a setup without a punchline, you know? Because making out is like, don't you wish I'd get somewhere? Yeah. So did I. It was horrible, I had blue ball pain, combined with holding in the fart pain, you know? And that's a dangerous combination right there because I got a liquid blocked up right next to a gas. I'm worried the pressure's gonna build up, something's gonna burst, they're gonna combine and form a cloud in my taint. It's gonna fart out of my dick and then the rain will knock her up, you know? I'm no Christian scientist, but I'm pretty sure that when a magical jizz cloud impregnates a virgin, that kid's gonna be the Messiah. Or autistic. Either way, private school is going to be expensive. All right, thank you guys very much. My name is Louis Katz.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Marina Franklin is taking the stage when we return.
We'll be right back. are back. We're back now. I fucked up and did it early. I said we're back twice. Oh, by the way, in case you were wondering, I do shave my pubic hair. When I'm nude, I look like a tall infant. I even sound like one when I come. I go, Your next act, I have worked all over the country with. She has been seen on The Late Late Show with Craig Ferguson, and she is hilarious. Marina Franklin, let her hear it.
So my name's Marina, which is not a great African name. Okay, I did not get one. I apologize. My sister did. Her name's Naila, which means one who succeeds. Marina, that's me, means a place where you dock boats. Okay. And you can take that any way you want to. My mom just had different plans for me. She was like, this one's gonna be a whore. Yeah. Oh, thank you. Thanks. Yes, you can applaud that. Originally from Chicago, that's where I grew up. That's the hometown of Barack Obama, our Lord and Savior. Okay, thanks for knowing that's a joke. Everybody, some places they don't know that and they get really mad. He's not your fucking savior. I know, it's a joke. I love Michelle Obama. I think she's just so classy and just such a lady. I was actually thinking this. She's from Chicago. I'm from Chicago. I could have been a first lady. But they would have done that background check. And I ain't no lady. Like, Michelle looks like she always knew she wanted to be a first lady, you know? It don't look like she went through a slut phase. I did. Slut phase 1, 2, and 3. There's a fourth coming. I hope. Every man always wants to know how many men you slept with. I have always lied about that. As the president, he could find that shit out. Like, if he asked Michelle how many men she slept with, she'd be like, baby, I'm your first lady. Aww. If that was me, it'd be like, what? Well, what had happened was... I'm your first hoe! Surprise! Thank God you guys laughed at that joke, you know. Sometimes they don't, and it really makes me feel like a hoe, you know? Like, sometimes they just listen to that joke, like, that's a hoe just telling a story. And we just listen to it. It was like a little hoe fairy tale she just took us through. She took us on a little hoe journey. So thank you guys for knowing, you know. My ex did not like that joke. That's why we're not together. Yeah, he was like, oh, you're saying something about yourself. Yeah, I just got out of a relationship, which I'm fine with, you know, and I'm enjoying my single life. I'm not going to look for a man. Because usually when you're looking for a man anyway, you're not going to get one. That's like the rule. When you're looking, you have that you know, that look. You know, Like, where is that motherfucker? It's just, it's too desperate. A guy can see that a mile away. He's gonna be like, that bitch is crazy. You cannot be that desperate. It's usually when you're not looking, that's when it happens. When you're happy, enjoying your single life, that's when a man's gonna look at you like, ooh, yeah. How can I destroy her? Huh? That bitch is too happy. Can't have all these happy bitches walking around. I'm taking that one down. You gotta stay focused. My ex was younger than me too. 11 years younger, yeah. I know some of you are doing math right now because you're looking at me and going, she looks young, so how old could he have been? 12, let's just go with that. Let's go with that number. He was young and white, so not a cougar. Black Panther. Oh yeah, I was a real predator. Mm-hmm. Meeting his mom, now that was a situation. Cause he had to tell her ahead of time that I was older, 11 years, black, that's a lot. I couldn't wait to meet her. Cause when I met her, I told her, I got your baby boy. Oh yeah. We gonna mix some Obamas up in this bitch. We gonna mix it up. We gonna stir that pot. This was the whitest guy too I ever dated. And by the way, I don't just date white guys, it's just the economy was bad, so. You know, it's like a storm is coming. So I need my white guy. But the whitest guy I ever dated, never been around black people his whole life. His only experience with black people before me was watching The Wire. Wu-Tang Clan. Like, my fear is, I don't think I was black enough for him, you know? Like, I think he wanted it blacker, you know? Like, I think he wanted the real, you know, that, you know, that, that, that shit. Hell yeah. Doing? Shake a dang guy. Shake a that. That energy is so exciting. And this is just me. Hollywood loves sassy black women, you know? They love it. Oh, I get it. So, you know, commercials, they use it all the time, you know? Because that's the power of Pine Sol, baby. Like, oh shit, I'm gonna get some Pine Sol. That was exciting. I live in Harlem. Harlem, which is, yeah, thank you. Harlem has changed. It, you know, there are white people. It's gentrified. I've been saying gingerfied, which is different. Changing Harlem one redhead at a time. But Harlem is, there are white people in Harlem now, and you can tell there are signs. You know, like we got like Starbucks is there and a salad. White people bring salad. It's great. The first time I saw a ripe tomato, I was like, ooh, they coming. That is a nice tomato right there. Dating interracially was difficult though, you know. People would vocal, and there was a guy, he didn't like the changes. He was going off of, he's like, I don't like this shit. This revolution, better recognize. On that block, they're making $100,000. You ain't safe, don't be comfortable. Don't be comfortable. My boyfriend at the time was like, I am not comfortable. Thank you, you guys have been wonderful.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV. Live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City, Colin Jost is taking the stage when we return. Welcome back to the Access TV presentation of Gotham Comedy Live. More laughs happening right now.
We're back. I told you we'd be back, and we're back. You guys are having a good time, am I correct? You might recognize your next comedian. He's been seen on the Jimmy Fallon Show, and he is also one of the head writers on Saturday Night Live. So make him feel good, Colin Jost.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Oh, thank you. How is everyone tonight? Good? Happy Easter to everyone. I should say to all of you Christians, happy Easter. To all the Jews out there, I say, nice try. Better luck next time. I was just in Vegas doing shows before this. My favorite thing about Vegas is why when people get there, they're suddenly obsessed with buffets. A buffet for me is the thing where it's the biggest gap between what I thought about something as a kid and what I think about it as an adult. Because as a kid, I was like, oh my God, I could have Chinese food and Mexican food. And as an adult, I'm like, oh my God, I could have diarrhea and still shit my pants in half an hour. I was driving around there. I love driving around because I live in New York and I don't get to. And I love all the songs on the radio where they have to change the lyrics to make them radio friendly. The one I kept hearing was that Enrique Iglesias song that's like, tonight I'm loving you, whoa. I don't know if you know, originally that song was, tonight I'm fucking you, whoa. A very forward gentleman, Enrique Iglesias. So they changed that lyric, but they left the rest of the lyrics the same. So it's like, girl, I don't mean to be rude, but tonight I'm loving you. I was like, actually, that's not rude. That's one of the kindest things anyone has ever said to me on the floor of a nightclub. My favorite of all time, though, is the Black Eyed Peas song, Let's Get It Started. Originally, that was Let's Get Retarded. Great songwriting from the Black Eyed Peas. So they changed those lyrics. My dream is there's a whole generation of kids now who's gonna be like, that dude's retarded. And it's gonna be like, no, Billy, we don't use that word anymore. He's not retarded, he's just getting started. any True Blood fans here? Anyone watch True Blood? I had never seen it, and my friends were like, I had never seen it, and my friends were like, oh, you gotta see the show True Blood. It's about these southern vampires. It's so sexy. I was like, I can't think of anything less sexy than a southern vampire. Just a dude in like a cape and a trucker hat, drinking blood out of a can. This here's my cousin's blood. One fang up, one fang down. It's like attacking people at NASCAR rallies. My favorite show, though, now is NCIS on TV, NCIS. 18 million people a week watch NCIS. Zero of them know what it stands for. Ask someone, you'll be like, hey, you watch NCIS? They'll be like, fuck yeah. I'll be like, what does it stand for? They're like, I think it's like CSI plus the N-word? I don't know, I have no idea. I looked it up, they solve naval crimes. I was like, what the fuck is a naval crime? Like, you show up, you're like, are you okay, ma'am? I was hit by a submarine. Oh my God, are you okay? Yeah, it's fine. I was in the water, so it just sort of pushed me to the side a little bit. my name's Colin Jost, which is kind of a weird name. It's not that weird, but people have a surprising amount of trouble pronouncing it. Like, even the word Colin, when I say it to someone, instead of trying to repeat it back, they often just change it to another name they know better. So I'll be like, hi, I'm Colin. They'll be like, Alan. And then Colin Powell has just destroyed it for anyone ever named Colin throughout all of history. Because now once a month someone's like, is it pronounced Colin? I'm like, yeah, my mom named me Colin. She was like, oh, here's a baby boy I love. What should I name him? I know, I'll call him after that section of the body where all the feces pass through. And I'll name my other son Urethra. Urethra Franklin. Thank you, thank you. Applaud for my brother. Even my last name, Jost, it's weird. Jost, J-O-S-T, people pronounce it Jost or Yost or Joust. Even when I spell it on the phone, whenever I say the T at the end, they think I'm saying E. So they're like, let me read that back to you. Colin Jose. I'm like, yeah, I'm Irish Mexican. You see a lot of that, dudes with brown skin and red hair eating corned beef burritos. Just like a tiny leprechaun running around with a sombrero. Like, where's me lucky pot of gold? How do male gynecologists have sex, right? It's just the worst. They're like in a clinic looking at vaginas all day, and not even regular ones, like the worst ones. And they have to turn around and just shut it off and have sex? It'd be like someone came back from Vietnam and they were like, laser tag? What do you think? Vietnam buddies, should we go in the woods, hit each other with paintballs? Right? Are there any couples here? Anyone dating? I heard three women, that was great. Here's my advice for couples out there, okay? If one of you is gonna lose a bunch of weight, you better both lose a bunch of weight. Because there's nothing worse than seeing a couple you haven't seen in years, and you're like, oh my God, Mark, you must have lost like 50 pounds. And Janet, hey! Janet. Anyone here date online? Any online daters? Why are you responding? The correct response is just shamed silence. My favorite ads on television now are ads for ChristianMingle.com. Oh my God. ChristianMingle. Doesn't it just sound filthy? You know something is going in a butt on that date. It's like, whoa, we were just mingling, and then all of a sudden, but we're still Christian. It's so coy, too. You know, the other websites are straightforward. It's like, match.com, we'll match you up. JDate, you're Jewish, go on a date. Christian Mingle. Just call it what it ends up being at the end of the date. Christian handjobs. Did I say Happy Easter? I never stood J-date either. It's like, are you a Jewish man looking to meet exclusively Jewish women? My Jewish friends already have that dating service. It's called their mother. There should be a website called J-scape, and it helps Jewish men meet anything but a Jewish woman. And it just redirects to Christian handjobs. Sometimes dating in New York, dating in person can be even weirder than dating online. I met a girl the other day. Girls can be very aggressive in New York. I met a girl, we were just talking, one of the first things she said to me up front was, just so you know up front, I'm like the queen of giving blowjobs. I was like, what a merry coincidence. I'm the king of receiving blowjobs. Oh, what are the odds? Surely 'twas meant to be, m'lady. Also, no, you're not the queen of giving blowjobs. What, she's gonna get back to the apartment, she's gonna be like, you never saw this move before. every blowjob. Because there are only two types of blowjobs in the world, pretty good and really good, and they're all really good. Because any type of blowjob you get is so much better than not getting a blowjob. Thank you guys very much.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Lynne Koplitz is taking the stage when we return. Welcome back to the Access TV presentation of Gotham Comedy Live. More laughs happening right now.
Are you ready for your final act of the evening? Hilarious. You may know her from the Joan Rivers show. Joan knows best. Let's hear it for Lynne Koplitz.
Aggravating. Okay, first of all, I actually tried tonight. This is me trying. Is that sad? This is... Don't shut up. This is how much I've started giving up lately. People have been asking me if I'm from Michigan. Is that so sad? I'm just done. It looks exactly the same. I'm not being... Is anyone from Michigan? Yeah? Look at that one little sad guy. It's not a bad, I like Michigan. A lot of fleece. If you've been there, there's a lot of fleece. My sister just met, we should all go. We're all, like, you girls are off the charts. I'm a fucking 12 in Michigan. I went there, my sister lives there now, and I went to a cocktail party at her house at Christmas, and there was a woman, I swear to God, at a cocktail party in what looked like a belted Snuggie. I was like, bitch, what are you doing? I know a Snuggie. I have three. Just because you put a belt and buttons on it, I know what it is. That's how old I've gotten now, where I'm wearing the embarrassing shit, like the gag gifts, I wear them for real. Like, I got off the plane, my sister's like, are you wearing pajama pants? I'm like, she's like, that's a joke. I'm like, joke's on you, bitch. I slept 3 hours. But I'm in a real bra tonight, which is very fancy. I'm not even comfortable having them this high up. It's very bizarre. You can usually find me in a sports bra. Nothing says I'm done with life like a 45-year-old woman who does no sports, who's in a sports bra. And I don't even buy the expensive ones. Stop applauding. We'll never get through this fucking show if you keep applauding and stuff. And I don't even buy the expensive ones. I buy those ones from Target, which there's no support. They just kind of rally the boobs. So there's just one big angry breast, just kind of low rise. Even homeless guys, like, I go to give them money, and they're like, eh, it's okay. I see that one big mean titty. I mean, it's so old. I'm distracted by my drink. I'm like, fuck these people. Ooh, I love alcohol. And so I'm really getting old. I used to, somebody the other day told me I was a MILF. Do you know what that is? Yeah. Moms, I like to fuck. It's a compliment, I suppose, if you're a mother. I'm not, so I found it a little insulting. I said to the kid, I'm not a MILF, I don't have children. You're still a MILF? Yeah, okay, no. I don't have children, I can't be a MILF. He was like, you're an ILF. It's nice to know that the special needs people find me sexy. I used to be, you said, oh, you're so young and sad, look at you. She's so sweet and beautiful. How old are you?
27.
Oh, you giggled because you're at the end of young. 27 is the end. It's so sad. It's the end of young. Are you white? You're a white girl? Listen to Auntie Lynne. I don't know if you can tell. I'm not really doing comedy anymore. Surprise. I'm more about information now. My life's over. And I don't have my own children. I see the whole, like the prophets who've come before me, I have things to tell you. Now listen to me. not Jesus prophet, more like Simon and Garfunkel. You're too young. Listen to me. Listen, I'm this girl. See this girl next to you? She can laugh whatever she wants. God knows how old she is. She get a shot of her. She's an Asian girl. She's probably 4,000 years old. No one. These ladies too, get them. Fucking women of color. I can't stand it. They don't age. Nubian princess, she'll look like that forever. White girls right here, stop laughing, white girls. Stop laughing. Let me tell you why. Because white women, we age like bananas. Listen to Auntie Lynn. Right now you're laughing. 20 years from now, you're gonna be looking in the mirror going, what the fuck was so funny? Because you're a little green banana till you're in your 30s. You're a green banana. Anything is possible. You could end up in a bread mix and cereal. Someone might eat you all alone. Who knows? It's so exciting. Then in your 30s, you're right. That's why, boys, listen to Auntie Lynn. If you're dating a woman in her 30s, a white woman, and you feel like she's trying to trap you, that's because that bitch is trying to trap you. She knows she's right. You gotta peel the banana. We gotta go, 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 go. Before there's a bruise. Have you ever seen a bruised banana? For as long as it takes us to ripen, we rot that fast. Once there's a bruise on the banana, what do you have? You have like 3 days before it's not even recognizable. People are walking by the kitchen. What's on top of the refrigerator? The dog keeps barking at it. It don't look right. Okay, moving on. We don't have a lot of time. I'm out of breath from walking around. That's why I had to stop. I used to be a cougar. I had to stop cougaring because I hurt my hip. I wish that was a joke. I love young guys. I freaking love them. Look at these young guys. Look how cute. Oh, I love them. Even the one in the suit. There's so many young ones. Oh, that one's too old. No, you're cute, but I don't like old. Like, you probably have opinions. I hate that. I hate opinions. That one with the collar and the opinions. See, let me tell you something, young girls. Listen to Auntie. That guy, there's nothing wrong with a guy in their 40s, but he has opinions. See this kid right here in the t-shirt? I could blow that kid into changing his religion. Right there. One good ball tickle, a pinky up the bum hole, that kid is following jihad. I love young men. I had to stop because I hurt my hip. This is a true story. I'm in the middle of doing it with this kid. He's 26, I'm 45. And he's got my leg like this. And here's the thing, we hadn't discussed it. There was no discussion. Because when they're young, when you're older, you have a plan. You go in like, let's open with a 3, close with a 6, okay. You don't even have to. Like, if you're really older, like, I mean, I dated a guy who was 50. It was fabulous. I'm like, we could do this, but what? You blow your knee out, and my neck is funny. I have chocolate eclairs. Let's just watch Castle. This guy's got my leg. He's pushing on. I heard shit clicking. I'm like, this is not good. I'm like, I don't have good health care. What is he doing? It was my fault. I had no safe word, and I couldn't expect this Brazilian douche to understand El Stapo. I sound tough, don't I? I have to go home. I'm excited. I live right near here. I can tell you, because I'm not scared of anything anymore. You hit an age where you're not frightened of anything, especially when you've lived in New York 18 years. What am I going to be scared of? You can't rape me. I'll kiss you on the mouth. How are you going to rape that? This is so unexpected. I hate rapists. If anyone's watching this, you're a rapist, I fucking dare you. Try and rape me. You crawl in my window, you're crawling out half the fucking rapist you were when you crawled in. I'm raping you. I'm gonna mouth kiss you. I'm gonna whisper, I love you, I love you, I love you. I gotta go, good night, God bless you.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Welcome back to the Access TV presentation of Gotham Comedy Live. More laughs happening right now.
How fucking good of a host was I to run this shit show on time? A hand for all your comedians, Lynne Koplitz and Colin Jost, Marina Franklin and Louis Katz. Thank you all very much. That feels fucking good.